On Sunday, the 29th of October, 1838, 11 fishing vessels manned by 26 men left the Devon harbour of Clovelly to fish in the Bristol Channel. After a storm, only two boats returned with the loss of 21 men. Four months later, it was reported by the Morning Post that yesterday a public meeting was held at the London Tavern, Bishopsgate, for the purpose of forming a fund for the relief of shipwrecked mariners and fishermen, or in the case of loss of life, for their widows and orphans. 175 years later, the Shipwrecked Fishermen and Mariners Royal Benevolent Society is still doing just that. I'm Paul Rose, and I lead science expeditions in the polar regions and mostly at sea. At the moment, I'm working for the National Geographical Society, leading their pristine seas expeditions. Our main aim is to reveal and save the last wild places in the ocean. My work at sea is something that I dreamed of even when I was 11 years old. I was in Romford, Essex, which is where I grew up, which is a long way from the sea. And I just knew at 11 I was going to be a commercial diver and work out there at sea. And by some sort of miracle, I pulled it off. Seafarers and the seafaring way of life is absolutely essential to our island nation. We're so very proud of our maritime heritage, aren't we? We just absolutely love it. I like to think that everybody in Britain has a bit of a seafarer within them. We're all defined by the sea, you know. You can't work in the largest, least understood, and arguably most powerful ecosystem on the planet without having a few hairy moments. And I remember delivering boats from the Azores to the UK, which really it's a sort of a holiday journey. People do that for their holidays. But wow, you get those storms coming in from the Azores out there and you just feel just tiny. You're just a tiny little dot in this world's most powerful place. And similarly, my work in the polar regions is often at sea. And of course, that means it's a lot of ice. And there's something, wow, there's something very, very powerful about being on a ship with an immeasurable amount of ice pushing against that hull and being stuck for a few weeks. You can't get off, you're just stuck there, and you feel very vulnerable indeed. The work of the Shipwrecked Mariners Society is absolutely essential, because for those of us that live at sea, we know it's a dangerous place. So everybody that's out there, whether they're commercial fishermen, whether they're sailors, whether they're people working on the offshore installations, if things go wrong, we need support, we need guidance, and we need some financial help. And that's exactly what the Shipwrecked Mariners Society does. It's absolutely essential. The charity's title is now more of a metaphor for the work it does. Although there sadly still are shipwrecks, mostly single-manned fishing vessels, most of the people helped these days are retired and finding it difficult to make ends meet. Either they can't find work ashore, or after a lifetime at sea, are suffering from accidents or ill health. As a maritime explorer, I know firsthand of the dangers of a life at sea. And despite advances in technology, it's still a risky business. But I choose to do it. However, life ashore can be equally tough, but in a completely different way. When you're retired and on your own, or unable to find work as a former mariner, then support from a charity like the Shipwrecked Mariners Society can make a big difference in the quality of your life. And that work is as important today as it was 175 years ago. And that's why I'm encouraging you to support that work.